Hi guys, welcome to my channel. If you're new to the channel, this is Favy's Fair. So join me guys, let's make egusi soup. So here's the pot. I had my oil to eat, then allow the oil to hot for some minutes. It's not up to 2 minutes yet. So allow the oil to hot. I added onions to it, and also to my egusi. I've soaked the egusi and also sliced some onions. So I'll be adding my egusi now to eat. You can decide to add it one or if you want that soup pattern, but I actually add mine once to the pot, then I stir. So this is the frying method. So I have to fry the egusi for some minute, then I had my meat stock, fish and the rice. So for this I have to cover the pot to allow the egusi to boil. Yes, the most dangerous thing about egusi is when it's not fully boiled, it's not fully cooked, it's not good for the frying at all. So I like frying my egusi and ensure that it's well cooked. So this is me frying the egusi. Like seriously, I have to mix it very well, and I have to test it. And my grandmom always liked this particular method. Anytime I put up egusi, he usually asks me, are you using the fry method or the other one? And anytime I told her that it's not the fry one, you'll be like, oh, I'm not going to eat. But once I'm using this one, I like eating. So the egusi, I have to add my pepper to it because a little bit fried, but not that too much. So I don't want it to be cooked a little bit, so I add my pepper to it. I stir together and I allow to boil again. So let me know where you're watching from, and so I can send you a hug, and let me know what you want me to do next. Yes, on this channel, what you want me to prepare next, let me know so I can prepare it for you. So these are allowed to cook, then after some time I mix together, allow to cook again, then for some time I mix together because I want the egusi to be properly done. So at this point my egusi is actually done. Yes, it's actually done. So there's one thing I usually do. I had my belly meat, like those liver, chakli, pomo. I usually add it on time so the egusi can enter in time. Guys, the secret, this is one of my secrets. If you want your beef, everything to come together with your egusi, like you want the egusi to enter inside well, like I mean well, you add it and fry it together with the egusi. And this belly of meat, I've actually washed it very well and I've spiced it and I steam it, so it's done. No, I'm not saying I've done. The belly of meat is done. Like, it don't cook. The belly of meat don't cook well. And so, of course, I always enjoy it when it's soft. So, this is soft. I have it to eat and I stir together. Like I stir together, I allow to cook again, and I also stir together to ensure that everything mixes. So I'll be adding my stock fish next. To the pot after adding my spice. So I'm going to use Chicken Glory and egusi spice. That is what I'm using. There are different spices that you can use to prepare your egusi. The sweetness of egusi does not rely on the spice. Yes, guys, seriously. It relies on the step you follow and ensure that everything you add to your egusi is well cooked. That is when you get the beauty and the taste you want or you desire. So you can use any spice of your choice. Can use any spice, but just ensure that the pepper is done, the egusi is done, the meat is well cooked, and everything are combined together well. Take your time and cook your egusi soup so you know go and push. Like, guys, I'm telling you, if you eat my egusi soup, you will never poach. Yes, my grandma is a full witness of it. If you eat my egusi soup, you will never poach. So I had my stockfish to eat dinner. It means very, very well, as usual. At this point, my grandma has already come to the kitchen, spy, and go back. If you have watched to this point, I'm grateful you watched to this point, and thank you for watching to this point. Thank you so much. But please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Yes, subscribe to Abana. Subscribe. You don't patronize me. Still subscribe to my channel now. Subscribe, guys. Share my video. Subscribe. So to this, I had dead mangi, as you see, but the mangi was too dry. So what I did, I don't want to take much time. So I just used my blender to blend it. Then I had to eat. So I'm going to stir again to make sure everything is combined. Right now, I'm testing my egusi for spice. So if the spice is okay to my taste, at this point, it was okay to my taste. Yes, it was okay to my taste. So I had my crayfish. I didn't actually blend the crayfish. Yes, I did not. So I just add it like that. You can add, you can. So I'm adding pepper. Kimberley pepper, black pepper. Black pepper, kimberley pepper. You can use any of these two. When I tasted it, there was no pepper. Like, pepper was not that much. And I don't like it much. I just like it moderate. So I had pepper to it to make sure that it had the level I want. So for that light pepper can eat, for that there's no light pepper can still eat the food. So that is my main aim. So I test again and it was okay. So I'll be adding my meat stock. Yes, to the egusi pot. And this is goat meat. So I boil goat meat. I package some in fridge. So it was the meat stock I had to eat with some of the goat meat. Now I'm going to allow to boil very well. And after some time, I'll open the pot. Once it started boiling, I'll mix together and I'm going to add my ugu leaf. You can decide to use bitter leaf, anyone you want to use, but I'm using ugu leaf for this. Because my grandmother always told me this, that if you want to eat bitter leaf, you just prepare bitter leaf soup and eat. Why using bitter leaf for egusi? I understand people use bitter leaf, but I feel that is what she would just be like, if I want to eat bitter leaf soup, I will just have bitter leaf. Like, if I want to eat bitter leaf, I will have bitter leaves. I will cook bitter leaf soup. I want to eat egusi. Give me ugu leaf. Why are you adding bitter leaf to it? So that's why, no way for bitter leaf. If I'm doing egusi soup, I don't actually use bitter leaf because I know, grandma will always say something. Except it's based on order and the person needs bitter leaf to be the egusi soup. Yes, that is when I do bitter leaf. But this one, I know, is just only 3 plates I will be serving from this to sell, and the rest one will be for my grandmother and I. Guys, once again, like, share, subscribe to my channel, and let me know where you're watching from so I can give you a hug. for watching to this point, and I really appreciate your effort. I really appreciate your love, Vishane. I'm grateful and I love you guys so much. So I'll be giving you guys more of video. So please, when you see a notification of my video, click like, subscribe, and share. So at this point, my egusi is ready. I actually tested it and it was perfect to my taste. Yes, it was perfect to my taste. So I like to boil for some meat again, then I drop it and I need my swallow to eat. So thanks for watching my video again. I'll see you all in the next video. Thanks for watching. Bye. I love you so much. Bye.